Hello, YouTube. Welcome to Bub's World. Today, we've got some slabs. That's right. CGC has graced us with their presence. However, I did not purchase these, or I did not submit these myself. It's just the wait times. I've got a bunch of books that I want to send off to either CGC or CBCS, but the wait times are just too much. And my wife has pretty much promised to disown me if I send any more to PGX. I don't know why. She's just not a PGX lover. So I don't have any way to get graded books. But I have to say this, that it makes me now be more willing to pay more for a graded book that I find online. So if you dealers are out there, anybody selling books, be aware that the ridiculous turnaround times, the amount of aggravation now, the price increases, all those things that are built into grading now, and the fluctuation in the grading quality, in my opinion, or the quality of the slab, in my opinion, you know, the quality control has just been so erratic over the last 2 years that I just don't think that that it's worth. It's not as exciting to send books off because I'm almost like waiting for them to come back and, like, you know, hold my breath. So if you can buy a book in the condition that you want and the case looks good and it's got the grade that you're after, if all things converge, that calls for a premium, in my opinion. A couple of these books weren't necessary. One of these books is one I was after, and then I'll explain how I ended up with the other two. So we got three slabs to show off. So let's make me small and get to the haul. Yeah! All right, I know. I get a kick out of it every time. This might be a foreshadowing of things to come, as they generally are. Every now and then I throw a random book in the background, but for the most part, it's always something quasi-related to the haul. So we got some Tron. Betrayal, finally finished that set. I got two more books to pick up of the other run of it. And look at that, J. Scott Campbell. That's good. Red Sonja. All right, so kicking off the haul, this is the book that I was after. And then the other two, there's another story behind it. But this is the book I was after. There's a whole series of these, but this was the one I wanted. And it is Avengers number 7. With the Tron variant, and they even put Tron variant on the label, so it says Tron variant cover, Parker Robbins and Red Hulk appearance, Brian Michael Bendis story, John Romita Jr. and Klaus Janson art, and Brandon Peterson cover. I think he goes by Brando. Yeah, when he signs Brando. So this is from 2011, although it's signed 2010. And look at that. You could tell it was not pressed before it was sent in. There is one color breaking crease on there on the spine. And you got kind of a little rough corner there. I think it probably could have got a 9.2 with a press, but that's not enough of a grade bump for me to change it. Once it's in the nines, I don't get too fussy. I like 8.5s for the book, but I think that the 8 grade looks a little rough. Like when you see the number 8 down here, up here, it's like, you know, you probably could have sent that in and got a little better. But look at that, Spider-Woman wielding the Tron discs. Isn't that great? I just love that. I think this is one of the best of the group. They had, when they did it, they did like one for all the Marvel books that were coming out at that time. And some of them are really good. The Ghost Rider I like a lot. The Wolverine is okay. I'll get it because it's Wolverine, you know. And there's a great Spider-Man. But this one's my favorite by far, for obvious reasons. So good. And they're not all done by the same artist either. So the quality varies quite a bit between them. So there you go. 9.8 Avengers number 7, Peterson variant cover, it says, and Tron variant cover. So very cool. Super excited to have that. I love that. So this was the book that I wanted. I was looking at paying a raw goes for like 25, 30 bucks. If you're lucky, even sometimes they sell for higher. So a raw copy somewhere in that range. It's not one of the more expensive of that group. Like the Spider-Man one goes for like 150 sometimes. So raw. So to get this one slabbed, I was willing to pay more, you know, 40, 50, 60 bucks. Didn't have to pay that much. Sent in best offer. So one of the things I look for are buy it nows and best offers. And when I'm buying slabs, now this is my old, you know, tip of how I purchase slabs on eBay, right? So I'm looking for something that accepts offers, something that has a buy it now. That way I don't have to wait a long time and fight on an auction. And I'm looking for slabs that are shipped with free shipping. And the reason, and there's the exact reason why I look for free shipping. You might say, oh, Bub, they're going to ship that. It costs 15 bucks. So here's the deal. If you can find someone who's offering free shipping, that's a built-in discount if you can purchase multiple books, if they're smart enough to recognize it. Now, I've had a few in the past that are like, oh, well, I'm not giving you a $5, $10 discount. I'm like, dude, you only have to ship to one place. So once I decided I wanted this, I put it in an offer. It was not a lowball offer. It was a fair offer, and he accepted it. So then I didn't pay for it yet. I just took the accept, and then I went back into his other books that he had, his other slabs, because if he's offering free shipping, I know he's already dropping 15 bucks to send this to me. So what can I throw in that will decrease his shipping costs, which will save him money, and it will give me more room to negotiate on further books. So I picked up this 9.6 Danger Girl / G.I. Joe number 3 by J. Scott Campbell. You guys know I'm not the biggest J. Scott Campbell fan, but what else do I say? If they can manage to cut those legs off by about 2 or 3 feet, that works for me. So you see this one, it's about to trail. It probably finishes somewhere around here. But that's got cut off. Everybody's legs are hidden or bent. So it works. There you go. Danger Girl, G.I. Joe, J. Scott Campbell, 9.6. There's the back. So pretty cool. I'm digging that. And this I did make a lowball offer on. And he negotiated back up a little bit, but still ultimately I got it for less than the cost of grading. You know, so I picked this book up for just barely over the cost of grading. So that saves me from, well, having to grade. And then picked this book up for less than the cost of grading. So I appreciate that. And then this next one I picked up for less than the cost of grading as well. So the idea is by shipping these together, the shipping total for all three books, I'll show this next one here now, Witchblade Electra number 1 with a Michael Turner cover. Check that out. Check out the Electra on that. Isn't that great? There's Witchblade. I think it's one of those composite covers because it's Michael Turner, D-Tron, and J.D. Smith. So I think what they did was kind of move everybody around, and you know, so like maybe that's Michael Turner and that's might be somebody else. I don't know. It kind of looks like Turner to me. That looks like Michael Turner also, but then maybe somebody else did the background or something. I don't know. Or the coloring. So there you go. Devil's Reign Chapter 6, Witchblade Electra from old 1997. So this other one's from 2012. So the idea was to go ahead and get these two, all three shipped. He was it because he left the label on the shipping. He was able to ship all three for $18. So only $3 more on these two in order to get them all shipped. So at that point, he's saving money. You know, the dealer, the vendor, whoever, he's saving money because he's, if he had sold these individually to three separate people, he'd have been out another $30 in shipping between these two other books, 15 each. So that's a win for him. It's a win for me. And it gives me an automatic negotiation standpoint where I'm like, look, I know he's saving $15 if I buy this. So I should be able to work the price down some. And I was able to get the price lowered on both of these by 10 bucks. Each, which, like I said, brought it all the way down to below the cost of grading. So he's almost losing at that point, but he's able to offload them, get them all shipped out to one person. And if you ever sold a book on eBay, it's less hassle, it's less trouble. You just ship it to one person and you're done. So that worked out. So now I've got all three books. So we got the Michael Turner cover there. We got the J. Scott Campbell cover there. And then the book I was most excited about, We got Tron, with the Tron variant for Spider-Woman with Avengers number 7. So that's it. That's the haul, guys. I hope y'all enjoyed that. And a little tip on buying, you know, combining lots on eBay, especially for CGC, because, you know, you can say, oh, well, I can do that on a smaller book or, you know, a raw book, but you're not going to have the same effect, because a raw book, you can stack many more in and not raise the cost of shipping. That's already a known thing. No one's going to give you a big discount on that. But if, and it's only a couple bucks to ship a book, especially when somebody's, you know, throwing that media mail shipping out there. But this was priority. You knew he was going to be shipping it pretty good. So there you go. I mean, that's how you do it. Find somebody, CGC slabs or any slabs, I guess, and work them on shipping, because you know they don't want to have to package that more than once. So there you go. All right, we'll catch you next time in Bub's World. Remember to read a comic, and or at least the grader's notes, right? I should be able to do that now. And don't apologize for the glare. Bye-bye.